How to make your accounts look good in Excel. That's right, this tutorial will show you how to make your accounts look pretty. I'm Simon, this is Computer Tutoring. So if you are really wanting to know how to make your accounts easy to read in Excel, the best thing you can do is follow along by downloading this file. I'll give you the link down below, up above, so you can follow along and get the most out of this Excel tutorial. Okay, so what you'll need to know first is how to insert a row in Excel. So just going to right click on row one, just here, gonna go down to and click on insert here, and you have a new row inserted in your Excel spreadsheet. Next, you'll need to know how do I merge cells in Excel. So we're going to merge these top five cells across the first row by highlighting them. And then I want you to click on this button here that says Merge and Center. So click on Merge and Center. And now these cells are merged. So what are the benefits of that? Well, I can now type in the title to my account spreadsheet, which is Easy to Read Accounts. I type Easy to Read Accounts, press Enter. That's great. So now we need to add colors to our account spreadsheet. How do we do that? Well, we're going to go up and click on the cell that we want to change the background color. So this is changing the background of a cell in Excel. And then we're going to go to this formatting drop-down list just here. It's a little paint bucket just to the right. And then we're going to go down to and choose standard colors. Now, we've got 10 standard colors that we can choose from if we wanted to. And as you can see, as I'm hovering over these colors here, the colors are already changing on the cell. But say you want to make sure your colors are right, or how to make sure your colors are right in Excel. Well, we're going to click on More Colors here at the bottom. Now, it brings up the Colors dialog box. Inside the colors dialog box, you'll see a lot of these hexagonal colors. And if you feel that the one here is correct, you can click on it. But what I would suggest is going to click on custom. And there we can mix the exact color that we want. Notice here we have red, green, and blue values there. So you can go to your marketing department and find out the exact red, green, and blue values that they use for your corporate or for company branding. Let's say, for instance, here I'm going to type in 155 for red, press tab, 50 for green. Oops, make sure that I'm typing right. So 50 for green and 12 for blue. Comes up as a horrible brownish color. I tell you what, I'm just going to make that a little brighter. There we go. That's good. And then click on OK. And then your background color changes to whatever you selected, and you're sure that that color is right for your corporate identity. Now, say for instance, you now want to changing the colors of multiple cells in Excel. So in effect, creating column headers in Excel, we can highlight these multiple cells here from A5 across to E5. And then I can click on that same paint bucket here. Now, it remembers the last color I've selected. So I can click on that, and then these colors are changed there. Or if I click on this drop-down list here under recent colors, just down here, it will remember the last 10 most recent colors that I've used in Excel. Next, you'll need to know how to change the font in a spreadsheet. So what you do is click on the cell that you want to change the font of. So we're gonna click on Easy to Read Accounts, and then going to click on this font drop-down menu, as you can see here at the top. We're going to click on this arrow just there. I'm just going to zoom in so you can see, and click, and then you can choose whatever font that you're wanting. So I can, as I scroll down, I can see as I'm hovering over each font that the Excel spreadsheet is changing. Let's just zoom back to give you an eye. So you can see the Excel spreadsheet updates to show this font that I've selected. Now, just be aware that you can type in the font that you're wanting. So say I'm looking for Tahoma, I can type Tahoma, and you see Tahoma's come up available here at the top there. So now all I need to do is press Enter, and the font now is Tahoma. Okay, so how do we change the font of lots of cells in Excel? Then we can highlight from A5, click and hold your mouse button down, move across to E5, let go. And now we can click in the font drop-down list here at the top, type in Tahoma, press enter, and you can see the font has updated. Great. So now we need to change the font size in Excel. How do we do that? Well, again, we click on the cell that we wish to change. So in this case, A1. Then we're going to click on this drop-down menu just to the right of the font style or the font type menu. And that's the font size menu. You can then choose whatever size you want. Just a little tip here. Say I'm looking for a particular size. I'm looking for something between 18 and 20, but you can see in this drop-down list, I only have 18 or 20. What I can do is if I'm looking for, say, 19.5, at the top here, I can type 19.5, and then my font size will be exactly the size I need. Okay, so how do I adjust the font size of multiple cells in Excel? So firstly, I make sure that the cells I want to adjust are selected. So in this case, A5 through to E5. I can then use these buttons here to increase or decrease the font size. So again, this goes up by increments depending on the list here. So if I'm looking for something in particular, I just decrease it. Say I'm looking for 13. Then I need to go up to this here and type in 13. So now, as you can see, some of my text in the columns is spilling over into another column. I see here the running total, the A and the L, is now spilt over into column F. So I could individually go and double click on this dividing lines between each column to adjust the width, but that's going to take a long time. So you want to know how to adjust the width of multiple columns in Excel. This is how you do it. You select the columns that you want to adjust the width of, and then you can double click any dividing line between the columns, and the columns will automatically adjust their width to accommodate the text within them. Great, looking good. So now you might want to know about adding borders to an accounts spreadsheet. So you can do that by the borders button just at the top. Now, the quickest way to add borders is by clicking on this drop-down menu here and choosing the button here at the bottom that says Draw Border. So I'm going to click on Draw Border. And if I zoom in close, you can see that my mouse cursor has turned into a little pencil. And I can use that to draw the border. So say, for instance, I want a border down here. I can click and drag here. And so now I've got a border between the data and the column headers. Now, you may have noticed that your spreadsheet is made up of these grid lines. And they can interfere a little bit with the borders. It can make it hard for you to know where you've drawn your border. So we're going to remove them. And we're going to do this by going up to View here at the top, and then taking the tick out of grid lines just here. If I move back, you can see the grid lines have disappeared. And in fact, because I've got the draw border pencil selected, I've got these little dots here to help me draw any future borders. So as I said, the quickest way to add borders to a spreadsheet is by using the draw borders button on the home tab. And you can go down here and choose draw border. Now, let's say, for instance, we'd want to increase or change the thickness of grid lines drawn on a spreadsheet. So I can go down to and click on line or hover over line style. I'm going to go all the way down to the bottom and choose the thickest line style you can see here at the bottom. And now I'm going to draw another border across here. And you can see that that border is considerably thicker. Great, so now you know how to change the thickness of grid lines drawn on a spreadsheet. So let's see if we can make this a little prettier. I'm going to just click on this draw border button here at the top and just draw a border here at the top. Now, say for instance, I want a literal grid beneath to hold where my data is. So what I can do is go up to this drop down list here, go down to and choose draw border grid. So I can now start up in the top left-hand corner and drag down. And as you can see, I can draw a border grid. When I get down to the bottom, just make sure, there we go, I align it up. And when I think my border is correctly surrounding the data that I want it to, I can let go of the mouse. I'm just going to scroll up to the top to get to the top of the spreadsheet. There. Great. So notice that my border is a little thick, yeah? So I just want to thin them out a little bit. So how am I going to do that? Well, again, what I'm going to do is just make sure if I click on this drop-down list here, make sure my line style is thin. Okay, so now I'm going to go back and select all the cells that I want to put borders around. So it should be down to row 119. There we go. Excellent. And then I'm going to go to this drop-down list here again, and I'm going to choose all borders. So you see all borders there. And as you can see, if I just click away, that my borders or my grid lines are now thin. Makes it look more Excel-like, doesn't it? So again, as I can see, the bottom border I want to be thick. So I'm just going to click on this drop-down list here and just make sure my line style is thick. And then I'm just going to go down to this drop-down list here and I'm going to choose draw border and draw a border here across the bottom. If you make a mistake, if you've drawn a border, say I went up here and I didn't want to have this border, you can do one of two things. One, use the erase border button. So if I click on this drop-down, the border drop-down list here and go down to and choose erase border, I can then draw across the border that I want to remove. So that's the first thing I can do. The second thing I can do is use the undo button. So knowing how to use undo in Excel is of vital importance. So how do you do it? Well, you can use, firstly, the undo button, which is at the top just here. And every time you click on it, it will undo each step. So if I click on it, and as I'm clicking on the undo button each time, it's going through each step that I've undone. There we go. Oh, I've gone too far. So the question is, what if you undo too far in Excel? What do you do? Well, you can use redo in Excel. So that's what you should be using, redo in Excel. So the way you do that is by clicking on the redo button here at the top. So every time I redo, it redoes what I've just undone. Once you've finished using the draw border or the erase border button in Excel, you'll need to turn it off. Now you do that by clicking once on the button. Oops, there. Let me just zoom in here so you can see. So you click once on this button, like so, and you can see that that button is turned off. And if I zoom out again, you can see that little dots have all disappeared. If I click on the erase button, you can see these little dots here appear to show that we're in drawing mode or draw border mode in Excel. So just one more click here and that gets rid of that. And we're ready. We're back to normal Excel. So I think you will agree your spreadsheet is starting to look pretty good. So there is another problem. And to illustrate that, I'm going to imagine entering in another item. So as I move down my spreadsheet like so, I get to the bottom, and this is the 17th of December. Let's type in the 18th of December here, 2020. I could guess that this column is the description of what I'm doing. So I'm going to type in pruning, but I can't remember what column represents expenses and what column represents receipts or money received. So what I would like to do is know how to fix the top rows in a spreadsheet. And this is how you do it. So we're going to scroll up to the top. And it's known as freezing rows. So this process is known as freezing rows in Excel. Click on cell A6. And the reason we're clicking on cell A6 is because when we freeze rows in Excel, it will freeze everything above the row that we've currently got selected. Okay, so we make sure we've got cell A6 here selected. And then we're going to click on the View tab here at the top. And then go across and click on freeze panes. And we're going to go down to and click on freeze panes. So now when we come to enter our new, scroll down to enter our new item, our new job, basically, I can see it's pruning and I can easily see my expense and my received column. So I received £40 for pruning. There we go. Sometimes though, when you open a spreadsheet that somebody else has created, that your rows or your columns are already frozen. So the question is how to stop rows being stuck at the top in Excel. So how do you do it? How do you stop rows being stuck at the top in Excel? Well, you would go to View, you would go to Freeze Panes, and wherever you happen to be on the spreadsheet, you would click on Unfreeze Panes, and your spreadsheet is back to normal. A question I often get asked is how to create alternative row colors in Excel. Well, creating alternative row colors in Excel is possible by using Format Painter. Let me show you where that is. So on the Home tab here, the Format Painter is a little paintbrush looking icon just here. And using Format Painter Excel makes things, creating these alternative colors, very easy. The way you do this is we're going to select A7 across to E7 and change the background color of those cells to a light gray, just here. And then going to select the pattern. So in this case, I'm going to select cell A6 across and down to E7. So one white row and one gray row. And I'm now going to click on the Format Painter button. If you look carefully, you can see a dotted line that surrounds my selection. Now I will select all of the cells I want to apply the gray and white row formatting to. So if I scroll all the way down to the bottom, and when I let go and just click away to show, I can see that now I have created alternative row colors in Excel by using the Format Painter. Well, hopefully this goes a little way to answering how I should use the Format Painter in Excel. And it's just one of many examples of how to use Format Painter. Well, that's it. I hope for all of you that were following along, it's worked for you. Now, our next tutorial, we will be looking at percentages. That's right, working out, like teaching you how to work out how much VAT discounts, and also the percentage of expenses. So if you haven't already done so, make sure you click on the subscribe button and the notifications button so you don't miss it. If you've got anything out of this Excel accounts tutorial, make sure you give us a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching.